Very hard to understand why I should have to defend a salutation of this country.
I began my career with saying kia ora tolls here. It was a toll room, the supervisors in Auckland, that objected to the use of kia ora. The standard expression, of course, is good morning, good evening. I couldn't understand how kia ora could offend anyone. He insisted that it would only be good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. And to which I continued to say kia ora. There was a threat of dismissal. I said to Dr. Rangi Nui Walker, I'm being harassed at work, and I'm being harassed for the use of kia ora. Well, then the hit hit the headlines, and 4 days in the front page. Then the Prime Minister came back, Rob Muldoon, and he said, I've been overseas deciding the economics of this country, and I come back here and some gill wants to say kia ora. Well, as far as I'm concerned, she can say kia ora, so long as she don't want to say g'day blue. So with that approval from the Prime Minister, it was accepted throughout the country. Schools around the country wrote in and congratulated us for the use of kia ora. The Air New Zealand pilots would hop in and before they'd take off, kia ora. So I fought the battle, but it actually was the country that won the war.
Kia ora.
No fear, as far as I was concerned. What will be, will be. And I'd already been told by my grandmother, who had died in 1972, that this is far greater than just me. My grandmother taught me many things, many things. One of the things she taught me, ina kite koe te tahi mea he hakatikangia. Ina kore, ko rite koe ki taua he. If you see something wrong in front of you, then you must address it, you must correct it, because if you do not, you will become like it. We've got reo all around us at the moment, and it's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. But still, to quote Sir James Henare, tawhiti rawa tō tātou haerenga, te kore haere tonu, maharawa wā tātou mahi, te kore mahi tonu. We've come too far to not go further, and we have done too much to not do more.
Kia ora.